Hi, my name is Pong Ying, and I work on the Google Wallet team. I'm here to talk about the Wallet Objects API for native Android. I used to have a keychain full of these, different loyalty cards to take advantage of discounts and rewards. And these, I usually just end up leaving at home, unfortunately. I could have saved so much money. I don't think anyone but the most dedicated savers carry around all of their loyalty cards and offers all the time. To make it easier for everyone to carry around everything, Google provides the Wallet Objects platform. Wallet Objects is the concept of digitizing and storing all of your items in your wallet in the cloud and making them accessible from anywhere. And combined with a mobile app that has contextual information, we can make these items smart so they appear when you need them. For example, I have a test object with the geofence of this building. Whenever I enter the geofence, my wallet object appears in Now, and it can notify me that it's available to use through an Android system level notification. And we fine-tune the contextual triggers so that these notifications won't trigger when, say, I'm just driving by the office. This functionality allows developers to do interesting things. Let's say you have an existing mobile user base, and you want to convert users from mobile to another physical medium. One example, it's a mobile game, and you want to convert the user to a console. In the game, you could add a geolocated wallet objects offer for a console title to incentivize user action. With the offer saved, the next time the user goes to a geolocation you specified, whether it's Fry's, GameStop, or Best Buy, or some other retailer, Wallet will notify the user that the offer is available to use. They buy the title, and boom, now they're playing your game in the living room in addition to on mobile. Wallet objects can help with retail as well. Instead of all the coupons and offers that you need to remember to bring when you go shopping, you should just be able to save those offers from an app or from the web and have them notify you when they're relevant. Let's say I walk past a store in the mall and my phone notifies me that I have a coupon to save $20 off a purchase. I'm going to try to take advantage of that savings and check out if there's anything in the store that interests me. Cool. So you want to integrate, right? Let's go over how to create and save an object. The wallet object's flow is simple. You define the data representing the object and add a save to Google button that calls our function create wallet object with the object to save. The rendering is based on a template that gets populated by the information you define. To reduce redundancy, wallet object stores data in two forms. It's somewhat analogous to programming. The class data represents information that's common to all users, like merchant details. The object data represents information that's specific to a single user, like a specific discount or a barcode. All this information is merged, then filled into the template. We have a number of fields here and in this template, and any section without data is going to be hidden. Let's check out the code. First, we need to create the class. This code defines an offer class. We set the merchant and some offer details, some images, some subsections, and lat-long geolocations. Finally, we insert the class. Inserting the class needs to use a server-side REST API. Once you've created and inserted the class, you can create the object data in your Android app. This may look like a big wall of code, but it's your standard builder pattern defining an object. Here, I'm referencing a class I just created. I'm overriding some class fields and defining information that's specific to the user, such as barcode and messages. Once I have that, we can tie the object to a create wallet objects call and tie that to an image button click, and we're done. So if you want to remind and incentivize actions for your users, integrate the Wallet Objects API into your app today. For more information on the integration and a step-by-step tutorial, check out our developer documentation. I can't wait to see what you build. I'm Pong Ying, and thanks for watching.